Our lecture now is dealing with the trigeminal nerve. The trigeminal nerve is the sensory innervation to the skin of the head. It has three main divisions. V1, ophthalmic division. V2, maxillary division. V3, mandibular division. The ophthalmic division's boundary is the lateral edge of the eye. Maxillary division, boundary lateral edge of the mouth. Trigeminal nerve, look, this is trigeminal nerve, this is ophthalmic division, this is maxillary division, and this is mandibular division. It is the fifth cranial nerve, as you know. It has a general sensation and special visceral sensation. Now, the ophthalmic division, it has passed through the superior orbital fissure. It has a general sensation. Maxillary from foramen rotundum, also general sensation. While the mandibular one passes through the foramen ovale, it has a general sensation and special visceral sensation. The ophthalmic division, as you know, it passes, this is through the superior orbital fissure. Maxillary division, foramen rotundum, mandibular division, foramen ovale. The ophthalmic division, this is V1, so it will pass through the superior orbital fissure. Orbit is used as a way to reach the face and the nasal cavity. Ophthalmic divisions has three branches, frontal nerve, lacrimal nerve, and nasociliary nerve. Now, the frontal nerve again has a supraorbital nerve and supratrochlear nerve. The supraorbital and supratrochlear nerve supplying the scalp and the forehead and the upper eyelid, both. The lacrimal nerve supply the upper eyelid. The nasociliary nerve, it has three branches, long ciliary nerve for the cornea of the eye, anterior and posterior ethmoidal nerves for the nasal cavity, ethmoidal sinus, tip of the nose, and the infratrochlear nerve supplying the upper eyelid. So, the ophthalmic division all has general sensation, frontal nerve, two division, two branches, supraorbital and supratrochlear. This is supratrochlear medially, this is supratrochlear medially and supraorbital laterally for the forehead and the upper eyelid. The lacrimal nerve, this is the lacrimal nerve. No, this is the lacrimal nerve. This is for what? For the upper eyelid. Nasociliary nerve, this is the nasociliary nerve. It is for anterior and posterior ethmoidal nerve for the nasal cavity and ethmoidal sinus and tip of the nose. Again, another branch, long ciliary nerve, sensory to the cornea, infratrochlear nerve for the upper eyelid and for the nose. The maxillary division, it is for the skin of the cheek below the orbit. It has a zygomaticotemporal and zygomaticofacial nerve and infraorbital nerve. Now, the ophthalmic, the ophthalmic division to skin above the orbit, lacrimal, supraorbital, supratrochlear, infratrochlear, external nasal. Now, maxillary division for the skin of the cheek below the orbit through the zygomaticotemporal, zygomaticofacial, infraorbital. This is the red one. While the mandibular, the green line, the green color, to the skin of the jaw and face below the angle of the mouth, auricotemporal, buccal, mental. This is all sensation. While the nerve supply for the motor muscles of the face and the scalp is the facial nerve. Trigeminal nerve, as you know, it is the fifth cranial nerve. So, As you know, it has these three divisions, as we said, ophthalmic, maxillary, and the mandibular. Now, the maxillary will pass through foramen rotundus. Now, what are the, it is sensory only, general sensation through the foramen rotundum to the pterygopalatine fossa. Now, what are the branches? What are the main branches of it? Meningeal branches to the dura of the medial cranial fossa, ganglionic branch through its roots or branches, greater palatine nerve, lesser palatine nerve, nasopalatine nerve, nasal branch, the greater palatine nerve for the hard palate, lesser palatine nerve for the soft palate, nasopalatine nerve for the nasal cavity and the hard palate, and nasal branch to the nasal cavity. This other branch, the posterior superior alveolar nerve, it is for the maxillary teeth. This is important. Infraorbital nerve to the lower eyelid and nose and upper lip. Infraorbital nerve has its anterior superior alveolar nerve, also the middle superior alveolar nerve. The anterior superior alveolar nerve for the maxillary teeth, also the middle superior alveolar nerve for the maxillary teeth at their site. Zygomatic nerves, we have zygomatic facial nerve to the skin of the cheek, while the zygomatic temporal nerve for the skin of the temporal region. So this is the maxillary nerve. As you know, general sensation, maxillary enters the pterygopalatine fossa to the nose. Note the pterygopalatine maxillary fissure is a slit between the lateral pterygoid plate and maxillary bone. Pterygopalatine fossa is a space medial to the slit. Nerve branch, meningeal, the first one, for the dura of the medial cranial fossa. Second, ganglionic branch, greater palatine for the hard palate, lesser palatine for the sulci. Look, this is the greater palatine, and this is the lesser palatine for the soft palate. See, nasopalatine, this is the nasopalatine. So, from its name for nasal cavity and the anterior part of the hard palate, nasal branch for the, this nasal branch for the nasal cavities. Now, this is a picture show how pass the maxillary nerve through the pterygomaxillary fissure. The other branches are the posterior superior alveolar nerve for the maxillary molar teeth, infraorbital for the lower eyelid and the nose and the upper lip. It has anterior and middle superior alveolar and other maxillary teeth. Look like this. Fifth, the zygomatic branch, zygomatic facial, and zygomatic temporal, the skin of the cheek and the temporal region. This is the maxillary nerve, the skin of the cheek below the orbit, zygomatic temporal, zygomatic facial. We have here the ophthalmic, the skin above the orbit, lacrimal, supraorbital, supratrochlear, infratrochlear, external nasal. Note, these are branches of the trigeminal nerve to the face. Fullest of the branches of the trigeminal nerves, we can see it at the last of the lecture. Mandibular division, the skin of the jaw and face below the angle of the mouth. Green light here. Auriculotemporal, buccal, mental. Trigeminal nerve, the last one, last branch is the mandibular division. Through the foramen ovale, as we said in the beginning, that it has a general sensation, also a special visceral sensation. Now, what are the branches of the mandibular division? We show here that it passes through the foramen ovale to the infratemporal fossa. What are the nerves? Nervous spinosus, it is sensory to the dura of the medial cranial fossa, motor to the medial pterygoid, tens and tensor tympani and tensor palati muscles. This is the motor branch. Anterior division, nerve to lateral pterygoid, masseteric nerve, masseter, deep temporal nerve temporalis, buccal nerve sensory to the cheek. The posterior division, it has auriculotemporal nerve, lingual nerve, inferior vilar nerve. Auriculotemporal nerve sensory to the external auditory meatus, tympanic membrane, the TM joint, lateral scalp, lingual nerve sensory for touch and the anterior two-thirds of the tongue. Inferior vilar nerve, it has nerve to phylohyoid and mental nerve. The inferior vilar nerve sensory to the mandibular teeth, motor to the myelohyoid, and anterior digastric, and this is the nerve to myelohyoid. Mental nerve, it is sensory to the chin and the lower lip. The trigeminal nerve, that is the first brachial arch muscles, this is on the during development of the child or embryo, we find this, and it is not very important for you in this stage. Mandibular division here, it has a general sensation, as we said, and special visceral sensation. The first one is the nerve spinosus to the dura of the middle cranial fossa, motor to the medial pterygoid, tensor tympani, tensor palati. Anterior division, it has branch A, nerve to lateral pterygoid, masseter muscle, deep temporal muscles to temporalis, buccal branch, or the trigeminal, that is sensory of the cheek. Like these muscles, all these muscles are the muscles of mastication. The posterior division has A, auriculotemporal nerve, this is the skin of the temple, and scalp, external ear, and the TM joint, temporomandibular joint. B, lingual nerve, touched to the anterior two-thirds of the tongue. Inferior alveolar nerve, sensory to the lower teeth, that is the mental nerve, skin lower jaw, nerve to myelohyoid muscle, motor to myelohyoid, and the anterior belly of digastric. Zygomatic temporal, zygomatic facial, and infra orbital. Ophthalmic, the skin above the orbit, lacrimal, supraorbital, supratrochlear, and infratrochlear external nostril. So, above the orbit, we have the ophthalmic division. Below the orbit, we have the maxillary division. And the skin for the jaw and face that is below the mouth, the angle of the mouth, it is the mandibular division. Now, in here, we just collect these branches in a table. You can write that and see the full lecture here will be just abstract as the branches of each division of the trigeminal nerve, ophthalmic, frontal, lacrimal, nasociliary, maxillary, meningeal branch, ganglioric branch, posterior superior alveolar, infraorbital, zygomatic nerve, and each one is what for what? The sensation for what? Maxillary teeth, this is for this. Infraorbital for the lower eyelid. Zygomatic nerve, the skin of the cheek. And the mandibular division, we have the nerve spinosus, motor branches. Anterior division, we have nerve to lateral pterygoid, masseter, deep temporal, buccal nerve, and posterior division, the auricular temporal nerve.